private schools are often seen as the pinnacle of education, but sending your child to one can come with eye-watering costs. Tuition can cost up to $30,000 a year, and that doesn't even include extras such as boarding and application fees. So is it worth the price tag? We're joined by Dr. Nina Hood, education researcher and former teacher. Morena, thank you for being with us this morning. So is it worth it? What are the differences between private and public, apart from the cost, obviously?
Sure. So big question and no easy answer. And we're talking in generalities here, right? So not all private schools are the same, just like not all state schools are the same. I think if we're looking at what are some of the key differences, we know that on average in private schools, you generally have smaller class sizes. They have a restricted intake. They typically have smaller class sizes, a higher ratio of teachers to students. So that's one of the key differences. In some situations, you also have often more facilities, sometimes better quality facilities, but not always. So I think those are probably a couple of the really key differences that you see.
In terms of research, what does it tell us about those who attend a public school, those who attend a private school, and what the outcomes are for those students?
Again, huge amount of variation. So probably on average, you've got students, particularly when we're talking about secondary school level, students at private schools are achieving higher results in whatever qualification it is that they're doing compared to state schools. But in saying that, there are some absolutely terrific state schools where children are getting a fantastic education and are getting really fantastic outcomes. We don't actually have any research that looks at the long-term impacts. So we can measure it up to the end of schooling, but we don't know a lot about, well, what happens when young people are in their 20s and their 30s and their 40s? What are those long-term outcomes? We just don't know.
Yeah, we were having this conversation just before we came on air, actually, around, you know, you might pay $30,000 for tuition fees, but if you're living in a big centre like Auckland, where, you know, some of those really good public schools are in areas where housing is a million plus, and you'll find, you know, people will try and sell their house to move into the area. So the argument is actually it costs you more to do that. And so you offset that by sending your child to a private school, because in theory it costs you less, right? And this was a conversation you've been having as well.
So I have had it in the past with some of my friends of looking at the economics of it and, you know, do you buy a house in the school zone that you want, or do you think about private school fees? And so I think it is a really interesting conversation to be having, although we do know that those private school fees are on the upwards trajectory at the moment. And if you've got multiple children, that also does add up quite considerably as well.
Also, I want to end this with parents who might be thinking about whether their kids are missing out by not going to a private school, because again, I think the belief is that, you know, your children will get a better education. So what would you say to parents who are thinking that, that, you know, they want scrimp and save to get their children to a private school?
I would hate any parent to think that just because they can't afford to send their child to a private school that they're not going to get a good education, because I really genuinely do not believe that to be the case. I think we've got children across the country getting amazing educations in our state sector and also in our integrated sector as well. So I would really hate for any parent to think that they are not doing the best by their child just because they can't send them to a private school. For me, it's always about saying, okay, looking at your child, thinking about who they are, their personality, and then thinking about, well, what's the best type of school to serve them? And in some cases, that may be a private school, but it's not always going to be a private school.
It's stressful, isn't it? Gosh, we were talking about the fact that we've got little ones and you're already thinking about secondary schools and where you're going to send them, you know, and this is years out from the fact. Dr. Nina Hood, thank you so much. Really appreciate your time this morning.
Pleasure.